What's the difference between the Montreal Canadiens and a skunk? There's none. They both play dead at home, and they both get crushed on the road. And you thought I'd just let it slide. Ha! Golf has golf. So back to the game anyway. This is the first night part of this LP, and as you may notice, the music that plays during Wild Battles sounds a little bit different during the night. It sounds a bit more nocturnal, so to speak. And it's the reverse in Diamond, Pearl, and Platinum. Nearly everything sounds different except the battle themes. Okay, so now I'm back to Professor Elm's lab, and everyone's in shock. God damn it, Silver! You could have just asked, and maybe he would have given you a Pokémon. Wait, what am I saying? This is Professor Elm we're talking about! He wouldn't even give me his snack wrapper to use as a starter! So, if I remember, there's a policeman talking with Professor Elm here, and he's gonna ask me Silver's name. I could type in 3 question marks since he actually said he was named 3 question marks, and actually I think some people might have done that, naming him 3 question marks just because he said he was named 3 question marks, but no, I'm going to rename him Silver because that is what his name is. It's, well, what was Giovanni thinking when naming him Silver? I mean, sure, it's a bit more, cooler sounding than Blue, but not by too much. And speaking of Silver and Giovanni, I got a few answers regarding why Silver hates Team Rocket so much, and most of them revolve around the fact that Giovanni neglected Silver in favor of Team Rocket, and the snack wrapper is still here. Why didn't Silver just wrap it? It would have been better than the Totodile he nabbed. Yeah, I'm saying that as a joke, of course, but Totodile has got its flaws, so do Cyndaquil and Chikorita, to be honest, but I am going to explain each one's flaws and advantages a little bit later on when I explain why I picked Cyndaquil. So now Elm is simply flabbergasted by both Mr. Pokemon's discovery. A Pokemon egg! No one has ever seen that before! Well, except all those guys who played Ruby, Sapphire, Emerald, and Red, Blue, Yellow. Unscratch that. Fire Red and Leaf Green is what I meant. And Elm talking about the Pokedex reminds me that I completely forgot to swap modes because there's the National Dex mode and the Johto Dex mode. The Johto Dex has no numbers at all, and the order is all topsy-turvy compared with the National Pokedex order. And did anyone ever use the Johto Dex mode? I mean, every resource you can think of works according to the National Dex. That's why I never bothered remembering the Hoenn and Sinnoh Dexes either. Yeah, the road to the championship will be a long one. Well, the sooner you shut up, the shorter it will be. Okay, so now I think I'm going to be able to leave. Make sure that you go talk to your mom. I'm going to do that, if only because it unlocks a few more things. Namely, the ability to turn off the daylight savings time. And nope, that egg is still not in the roster. So I'm going to switch the Pokedex mode to bring it back to the traditional way. Thank God it's included. I don't know what I'd do if there were only the Johto mode. So I'm going to head out and talk to my mom. Well, my mom in the game, not my actual mom, because she's out on errands. We're completely revamping the backyard, so my parents are checking out stuff to buy in order to do that. So I just got, did that? Just say I got 1 Pokeball? Definitely looks like it. I'm gonna check in the bag just to make sure that, okay, he says the same thing. So I'm going to check in my bag. Once again, the Pokeballs are in their own pocket, and I got five! So, why didn't the game just say, I got five Pokeballs? Okay, nope, this guy doesn't talk about technology being incredible in every way. So, my mom's in the kitchen, presumably making more Cinnabar Volcano Burgers. A viewer suggested that Hurricane Katrina soup would go along with it just great. You know what? Screw that. I'm going to Kanto Fried Combusken next time. Okay, so now she's going to... Oh man, she can save money for me! Well, I could give her my money, and if I lose, I won't lose half of it. But there is just one teeny tiny problem. She spends it sometimes! Okay, so it's for stuff to go in your room, but still, it serves no purpose for battle at all. And even if I wanted to spend money for stuff to go into my room, I have no control over when it happens or what I get. So, yeah, the systems in the later generations are huge improvements over that garbage. Okay, so I remember that text, so she's going to ask me first if I want to save some money, and then the thing about daylight savings time. So no, it's not over yet. It's not going to be over for another 6 months or so. So finally, with the opening sequence out of the way, about 3/4 of an hour in, just to remind you, we can finally get on with our quest to become the champion. Oh, what does this guy want? Oh, I think it's the mandatory catching a Pokemon tutorial. Well, you all know how to catch a Pokemon by now, but I'm still going to show it to you just for the sake of completion. And yeah, I am aware I say that a lot. And yeah, I already showed it to you in Pokemon Red on top of that. Yeah, wiggle that cute little butt of yours, Rattata, because you're going in that ball. Okay, so that guy is apparently named Dude. Even red or blue sounds unbelievably cool compared to that. So just imagine gold or silver or Chris. K-R-I-S, the name of the female character in Crystal, by the way. But I was interrupted earlier on when I was talking about Silver and Team Rocket. You know, the thing about Giovanni neglecting Silver in favor of Team Rocket? It's really obvious in hindsight. I don't know why I haven't thought of that, but no, I have an idea why. It's simply because I have trouble coming to terms with the fact that people make children only to neglect them or abuse them or raise them the wrong way. I say if you're going to have children, at least know how to raise them and raise them properly. I, for one, am not going to have children because I know I would not be able to raise children properly. Because, yeah, you know, there is a balance when it comes to being loving parents and strict parents. My parents had that down pat, so I turned out just fine. But if I have children, I just know I'm not going to be able to raise them correctly. So the natural thing to do is simply not to make any. No one will suffer that way. I mean, nothing irritates me more than hearing a child or a baby cry or yell or something. It's like, make them shut up, please, please make them shut up. Every time I go somewhere, there's some parent that's completely unable to control their children, and they run everywhere, and they yell, and they cry, and ugh! But I'm sorry, that tangent lasted a little bit too long, even for my liking, but that's what I do best if you've been watching my LPs since the beginning, going off on tangents. And believe me, I've got a lot of things to say about all sorts of things. Explorers of the Sky, the movie events, and so many. There are so many things I want to tell you, but of course that's not going to be done quite now. And speaking of now, I'm going to finish off this video by healing my Pokemon. So join me next time, because then I am going to fight the first regular trainers in the game, including those roadblock guys from before. I'll get my revenge on them, alright!